So I just received my Chromecast from Google, the $35 streaming appliance that you plug into your TV, and I figured I'd show you guys how easy it is to set up. Chromecast is a tiny little HDMI dongle, HDMI plug on one side, and unfortunately there's a USB power plug on the other side. You gotta plug two things in, not as simple as they made it seem, but still pretty freaking simple. So let's see if it is the easiest way to watch stuff on your TV. First things first, you gotta plug it into your TV. Plug in the HDMI, and then plug, hopefully, into a USB port on your TV to get the power. That's the cleanest way to do it. It's the way I did it here. Otherwise, you can use that provided AC adapter. And the light will blink a little bit, and then it'll start blinking white. There you go. Now it is ready to set up, and you should, at this point, be seeing an image on your screen. So we're gonna go to google.com/Chromecast/setup in our browser, of course, the Chrome browser. And let's get you set up and watching. You have to download an app to actually set up the Chromecast. They have apps for both Windows and Mac. I'm obviously on Mac. Download is very, very fast. We'll open up that DMG. There we go. Mac app, drag it into applications. Takes a couple seconds. There you go. Fire it up. So, yep, we want to open it. Now we're going to accept some privacy terms. Probably means that Chromecast is just going to PrismCast. And then hang on a sec. We are on the hunt for my Chromecast. Mine is 4,912. Don't think they ship them in chronological order, but who knows. So now we're connecting, and you may notice that my Wi-Fi on my laptop turned off and started just randomly searching when this started connecting. I have no idea why this is. I don't know if it's a device-to-device direct connection or what, but something weird happens in the background. Anyway, you want to make sure that the code that comes up on your TV is the same code that comes up on this screen. So for me, that's my code. Cool. If not, there's a problem, and you should remedy it. I don't know what the problem is, though, so good luck. Anyway, enter your wireless password, change the name of your Chromecast to whatever you want. I just called it Chromecast because I only got one, and then it's going to join your wireless network. Obviously, the Chromecast does not have a network port, so if you don't have a wireless network, Chromecast ain't going to work. Now your Chromecast has been set up successfully. So let's start using Chromecast, and the first thing we're going to do is not be able to use it yet because we need to download the Chrome extension to be able to send content from our Chrome browser on our desktop or laptop to the Chromecast. It takes like 2 seconds and adds that little button in the upper right. So it starts playing this little video tutorial on using a new Chromecast. And so I'll close this little dialog box up here. Thing is, now that I've got a Chromecast, I'm not gonna watch the video on some stupid little laptop. I'm gonna watch it on my TV through my Chromecast. So I'm gonna go up to this little button and I'm gonna send my tab from Chrome to the TV. Now this is tab mirroring. This obviously same image is on one tab on Chrome on my laptop and on my TV. Now you'll notice there's a delay between the two. That's because what's on my laptop, the device itself is actually sending data to the Chromecast directly. Whereas when you use native apps like Netflix, YouTube, Google Play, you're just telling the Chromecast to go out to the internet and get the data on its own. So there's going to be a little bit of delay. There's also going to be some performance hits because you're basically streaming your screen to the Chromecast. So it's not amazing for watching video in this specific tab mirroring mode. So now that we're done, we're going to go back up to the little extension button and we're going to hit stop casting. And you'll notice that the TV stops showing what's in my tab. Takes a couple seconds and there we go. And now the Chromecast will return back to its resting state where it is, as it says right here, ready to cast. But let's test out some of the native functionality. Now, obviously YouTube was kind of front and center for this whole thing, so let's go to the best channel on YouTube, the Video Grandpa channel. That's at Video Grandpa Blog, not Video Grandpa, because some dude in Mexico has Video Grandpa and he's just squatting on it. Anyway, let's fire up some content from the Video Grandpa channel and see if we can send it over to Chromecast. There we go. Let's do the Ouya stuff. So, we start playing on the YouTube site, as usual, but you may notice I'm not going to use that button up at the top that I just used. I'm going to use this button right here on the player itself. Now, this engages the native functionality within YouTube that lets you send stuff to Chromecast directly. So you're not streaming your screen anymore. You're just telling Chromecast, hey, go out to the internet, find this awesome video that Video Grandpa did on the Ouya, and play it. And there you go. Playing directly from the internet, not playing on my laptop. I've still got control on my laptop, so if I want to, you know, pause or change the volume or whatever, I can do that, but it's not mirroring anymore. It's getting the content directly. Now, the same native functionality is built into Netflix. If you go over to the Netflix site after signing into your account, you can dial up a movie, and as long as that movie's available on Instant, you'll be able to send it to your Chromecast, same way you do on YouTube, and watch it on your TV. In this case, I'm dialing up My Sucky Teen Romance, which is a movie a friend of mine worked on here in Austin, Texas. It is available on Instant, so I'm going to start it playing on my browser, and then send it over to the Chromecast. So now it's playing on the browser. I click that same little button that I had in my YouTube player, tell it to send to Chromecast. Starts buffering on both of the machines. You'll notice that on the laptop and on the Chromecast, it starts buffering. And I noticed that Netflix took a little longer to get going in this whole mode than YouTube did. I'm sure this performance will improve over the next few weeks and months. But right now, it kind of spins for a little while and then starts loading. And you still have control from your laptop, so you can, you know, pause and quit and all that. But the actual content will start playing on your TV via your Chromecast. Here we go. Now I'm watching a movie. So that's it. Within the course of about 10 minutes, I had the thing unboxed, plugged in, set up, and I was watching internet content on it. And I really don't think it could be much simpler at this point. $35 price point, super cheap. For me, it's worth it so far, but I'm going to be messing with it more over the next few days, and we are going to do a full review on it soon, so check back for that. Till then, happy Chromecasting! Thanks for watching. You can follow me on Twitter at VideoGrandpa, Ty at TyRoot, and subscribe to this channel for all kinds of awesome videos.